So I usually make these songs last a little bit longer, but I'm not going to do that today because I've gotten a few reminders that my announcements can be fatty. So I don't want it to be that way. I heard some people say that my announcements were a little bit long, so I'm going to make them quite a bit shorter today because I want to give you enough time to do your things like spear throwing and sword throwing and arrow training and bat training and stuff like that. There was also a reminder that I have for Nerissa because she's getting better at being a queen right now. So Nerissa's going to be hosting a How to Be a Queen class, and obviously this is not a class for boys. This is a class for only girls. So this is going to be something different that we never had at the Heinlich Academy before, but I'm looking forward to give my students as much variety as possible. Because new kids are coming and the brochures are coming out and we're filling them up. So we want to fill them up with enough stuff that they have something to pick from, because that's the great thing about here is that you can pick where you're going to be going and you have schedules for that. So certain times to be doing things. Okay, so there is a few little reminders I have for you today. So, the very, very first announcement that I want to announce is going to be, actually I want to say the best for last. But the very first announcement is that Gregor's interview, because he was over the other day, he was over with me yesterday, and he was doing his practicing. And so we had one day where we did, so the 3 days in total of practice for this interview with Cecil Flickerman, which is what you guys should all know, right? So, I'll take questions at the end, thank you. So that's what he'll be doing. I want to remind you that we've kind of had a mix up with Gregor's schedule. Yesterday was in the afternoon, today will be this morning, and then tomorrow will be in the afternoon. Why are we doing it this way? Well, I have something special in the afternoon today. I'm going to be going out to see a movie with a very old friend from school. Now, this is way back when we were friends, and it was just a long time since we've seen each other, and I might not even recognize him. He is a male, and we're going to talk about what we've been doing, and I just think it would be neat to see him again, and we'll also be going to see a really funny movie, Hotel Transylvania 3, because we both share the same interest of liking crazy, funny, adventurous movies. So we're going to be seeing that as well. That means that choir day will be, it won't be canceled necessarily, but Katniss is going to be the only one there, okay? So Katniss will be there doing more things today, which is ironic because Lucas did that. But that's what we're going to be doing today. So that's how today is going to look. Now, I also want to give a little reminder for all my Underline Chrome Goal people. Because I kept getting visitations these past several nights, and I've been knowing them so well from talking to them and working with them and reading them. So we're going to be having a celebratory dinner at Do on Do's. It's a few miles from here. It's in a valley, And it's very, for those who have not gone there, I personally, I'm the very first person to go there. I have not been there yet. But I've heard it's a pretty nice restaurant. It has quite a bit of deluxe food. It has a movie theater. It has a swimming pool. It has all the accessories. So we're going to be going there, and we're going to be having a celebratory dinner tomorrow night. And why tomorrow night? Well, I'm going to get to that as the very last announcement, because I know that you will all be jumping for joy after I give this last announcement. You can figure out what it is, but just don't say it in my whole class. It's meant to be a surprise. So, another announcement is we're going to be doing something nice for our Underland Chronicle people, as well as bring them to Duhandu tomorrow night. We are going to make them a little something, like a little, like an art project, or just some like ornament or present that represents them that would be nice to give them. So it can be anything. Think of them from the book and in real life. Think of what they're interested in and give them something based off of that that's really sweet and you put effort into giving them that. So I really want you to do that today. So after I work with Gregor, we will all come in here, so you'll do, after I work with Gregor, and after you do your light arrow training, we will all be coming in here and we'll be making our decorative ornaments and presents. So, these things do not have to be exquisite, but they just have to be something that's just nice and you put a lot of feeling in it. Doesn't have to be too fancy. It just has to be something just fun and just fun to look at and fun to just, it's just something kind and nice and neighborly. So God's lesson is love thy neighbor. So I will be writing up a rubric right over here for that later on. I have not wrote anything yet, but I will write some things on there. So, the next announcement goes to, this next one goes to your progress, in your choir group. And also I want to give an announcement to, I also want to talk about your private sessions with me. So yesterday I brought in about three of you. I brought in about one, two, three of you that we worked. That was pretty decent. We got through it at a reasonable pace. And it looks like the three of you are really hitting the ballpark and really knocking it out of the park with your translating. And you really show passion and brain-watering for that, those prophecies. And even, you guys, particularly the people in the Hunger Games and the students who chose the Hunger Games for their book, even took extra credit in attempting to translate the prophecy of blood when you haven't even got to, like, the near end of the book. That's really, really big. So, I want to congratulate you for your overachieving. Overachieving. I'm really, surprised by that. So there's no problem with your reading goals there. There's no issue. So I want to give a little bit of congratulations, which is kind of why you all are coming to Toulouse. You all are coming to Duhandu's with me tomorrow night to celebrate these people. These three people that did a good job for me and are really serious and really enjoying the Underland Chronicles and show passion towards it are Jonah Myers, Pipson Peterson. And the very last person in this room is John Weary. So those are the three people. So Jonah Myers, John Weary, and also Pipson Peterson. Great job, everybody, for doing that. I'm really, really impressed. Although one of you did translate this prophecy, and you could be able to read it, which was Pipson. So Pipson deserves like a gold star right now. He is just a great student, and I really have not had him a lot, but I have been looking over his progress, and he's been doing so good with his bat training. He doesn't damage the bats. His Luxa, and everybody really, really likes him because of his efforts and his kindness, and just also what he's been achieving, like in ear training and like cooking and everything that he has taken, he has achieved. So congratulations for that as well. Now, along with the prophecy of blood, I will warn you I want to figure out where you are on your reading right now. So, for those who are doing, for my Hunger Games people, you do know that when we do go to Regalia, you're not going to be able to see the prophecy of blood because it is very badly written. It has like curly cues and also like has junk coming out of it. It said, and you probably will not be able to read it, even if you put a mirror up to it. No microphone glass is very flowery written and very exquisite. It's not really easy to read. So I recommend memorizing the prophecy and looking at the prophecy as best as you can, trying to get as much out of it as you can, and really like just knowing it down to your heart before we go there. Although it would be interesting, like I could see the room with Sanders' prophecies going in the Smithsonian Museum in about like a few years, several years, like a lot of years from now. And another little reminder is, I have arranged this before, but in like 1 year or so, we're going to be starting out a museum that homes fiction novels, particularly what the Edmonton leaders have brought in the books, including books like And Then There Were None, my books, and other books that we'll find out as well. So it'll be a museum. It'll be the Second Smithsonian. It's kind of a neat idea. I really am just starting to form ideas. I have to form all my ideas before I set it up, because I never know, and I don't want to give myself added pressure, so I've been working so hard. So there will be possibly a room with Sandwich's prophecies in that museum, so everybody can look around them. And there actually will be several rooms, because not everybody, what if you're in the middle of reading the series and you don't want anything to spoil? So there will be about 5 rooms. In the first room, one prophecy prophecy of Grey will be showed only. Second room, first 2 prophecies. Third room, first 3. Fourth, first 4. And then fifth is all of the prophecies, including the fifth one. So that is just what is going to be happening. I really don't know. It's going to take quite a while. I'm not really prepared to really think about that and really work hard on it because I have to get all my other things out of the way. But when I get time for that, I will. When I feel like I have enough characters and novels, characters come to my mention that I've read, then I will design the museum when I think that nothing else can come to my mind. But that will be taking a while. I do not know how long, but still. Okay, so the very last, well, actually not the very last announcement that I have. So I know that I'm talking a lot, and I know I'm moving quite at a fast pace, but I will accept a lot of questions today. So I just want to find out how you all are in your reading progress. So my Under Nine Chronicles, so how far are you? You're still on chapter 16, so you haven't gotten there yet. Okay. Okay, good. You don't have to read every day. When you're motivated, I highly recommend that when you're motivated, otherwise it'll just be a waste of your day. My Under Nine Chronicles, my Hunger Games rather, you should be on the part, well, you should be on chapter 12 right now. So the book is moving a little bit slower than the Prophecy of Bane because the Prophecy of Bane, it got right into it. He came to the Underland right away and they just really got into the prophecy and got into everything and they started super early. But I have a feeling that this book is going to be like the first book because it takes a little longer to get introduced to things and it's gonna happen in chapter 12. We're gonna set off on the quest. So what happened in chapter 11? Good, so they had their meeting. Yes, and also, I gave it away, he struggled to read the prophecy. Yes, now I know that some of you, the people that are reading, my students and my Hunger Games, are really, really struggling with this particular verse, and you will be able. So, when these three people were doing their assessments with me, they just skipped over that verse, and that is particularly fine because we're not aware of what that is yet. That is such a difficult verse. It wasn't there. I didn't know it. So this is the verse. It keeps repeating 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So verses 2, 6, 8, and well, I don't know. But it is turn and turn and turn again. You see the what, but not the when. Now, some of you may have an idea of what that is. Some of you may have just a prediction, a general prediction over what that means exactly, but you're probably wrong, and we just don't know for sure. So you'll be able to see as the book goes along. But don't forget that particular stanza, because just pay attention as you go through, and you will find, you will find it translating, but you're not aware of it, so. Definitely do not forget this particular stanza. Remedy and wrong entwine, and so they form a single vine. The last particular line, and so they form a single vine, that rhymes, is the one that I'm not too sure about. But I could see the first three lines being easy to translate. So that is just the prophecy, but you did a good job anyway with translating the rest of it, which is most of it, just that one little stanza that we have to work on, but good job. Okay, so then now that I've checked over your reading goals, now I want to check over what we're going to be doing in choir group today. Because today in choir group, you will be singing a new song, which, as I said, this is going to be a really, really pretty song. It's going to take you away, and there's a little bit of imagery to go along with this song as well. My voice is getting a little hoarse, but this song is called Always Something Sings, and this is the song that I said maybe about like a day ago or so, 2 days ago, that would be the difficult song. It would be the long, very long song. It's going to take a lot of time to learn and practice. But this song is going to be really, really pretty at the concert with the accompaniment and just all the harmonizing and the chords. And when you're singing the song, I just really want you to picture either two things. I want you to either picture riding on bats in the underland, gracefully soaring through the sky to find Gregor's father, or I want you to picture going down the waterway and going in a boat, particularly, this is one of the parts, to the island of the sand in the west in the cave. So that is the song that you will be starting today. If there anyone who did not get that presentation shared with you, is there anyone who did not get that presentation that I shared over the Gregor the Overlander songs? Because there's a lot of people here, and I might have forgotten you. So for those who, I will get that shared with you. Thank you very much for telling me, for raising your hand up. Okay, so with all the announcements gone and done, there is a final announcement. So this final announcement goes to a great little something, okay? This is not just a something. This is a creature in the underland. Okay, you know where this is going? I think you do. So I found out Miraz came in my bed last night, and he told me that Eris was going to be coming over tomorrow afternoon, and he is absolutely sure about that. And I am just like, oh, I'm kind of skeptical because, well, when people tell me that, it doesn't happen. But then he said that that they called him over and told him that, and they wrote letters to him, and they sent an email. So he is absolutely certain that they will be coming. We're going to be having a dinner at Do On Do's. We're not going to be having a dinner at Heal, just because there's too many other good things that we're meant to know doing that I'm really, really proud of. I think I want to go to Do On Do's because it's the proper place for all your great accomplishments over these weeks. So, we'll be going there with Eris. This is actually, is there any questions now that I'm done with my analysis? Yes. Oh, Luke said yes. Well, the thing is, when you get this restaurant, it is like a very, kind of very expensive restaurant. And the great thing is, you get a private room where no one is going to be around you and looking at you. So you get like, we're all going to be in a very long rectangular room with big tables where we're going to have a private dinner, a private big party dinner, because that's the party area, and no one will be able to look at anybody and like roll eyes, make jokes, because I will not have that. So that is just something, been quite a big reservation, but I'm able to get them to listen to me, and I'm able to have them do this. So great question. Is there any other questions? Yes. How about we save that question until after everybody's gone? So, is there any question that impacts everyone? So, this is not your individual question, because if it is, I will see you afterward. Then you need to head down to your archery training or wherever you need to go. So, if there's any questions, as I said, so any questions that impact the whole group. So, yes. Yes. Great. Oh, thank you for reminding me about that. So then, this is how the interview is going to work. So, Gregor is going to give his interview, and you will not need, I don't think that it will be important to tell you how it's going to work. That's just me and Gregor biz. But this is going to be something important. Thank you for reminding me, Gregor. After we're done with the interview, my Aunt Joan, who is the one who I will introduce her, she was the one who recommended the series to me. She will be standing up there and she will be talking about how much she likes the book, what she likes out of it, what she thinks of the book, and what a pleasure to have him there. And actually, when she's done with her speech, and she is a really, really big talker. She's just a sweet soul, and she talks a lot, and her dad fills the room, but she is very conversational, and she does not interrupt too much. So, and then after the interview, because it's such a special occasion for my mention, we're going to, all of you, every single person from the Underline Chronicles, so no Hunger Games for tonight, I'm sorry. Well, maybe if I decide that at the very end. But you just are going to be coming up at the very end, and you're going to be just talking about yourself. Just giving just a general gist of who you are and what your life is like, what was the scariest adventure you went on, blah, blah, blah. So that's all of you, including Aries, and everybody will be dazed by that. So every single person will be up there and will be in front of the whole audience, and it will be kind of nerve-wracking. But water will be endless supply of water there. So, that is all the announcements I have for today. My voice is really, really hoarse now. So, I'm going to stop talking and everybody can get where they need to be. Some of you have cooking lessons, spear throwing, sword training, arrow training, archery. You also have bat training, there's endless stuff, and also Queen Class will be starting the day after tomorrow in the morning. Okay? So, bye-bye. Vamos. Have a good day.